Hello, photographers in the Photography Academy community. My name is Tim Shields. I'm the founder of Photography Academy. And with me is Tonya Davison from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. And she has put together an amazing collage of family portrait photos that she took during the COVID lockdown. And it's just such an unusual project. I had to interview Tonya. So Tonya, welcome to the show here with me. Please tell me, how did you get this idea?
By news, basically. I saw it on a Facebook feed on a news story of photographers out there in the States going around and taking pictures of people, letting them have some fun during lockdown and doing it absolutely free. So I figured I'd get out there and try it myself.
So your idea was to take photos of individuals and families at their homes. Is that really what the idea was?
Yes.
Okay. And how did you get publicity? What did you do to kind of advertise and find subjects for your photos?
By posting up ads all over on Facebook through buy and sell pages and whatnot. So, and on my Facebook feed as well.
And so what did you say in your Facebook posts?
Basically, that I would show up. Before I show up on my way there, I'll send a message. Once there, I'll send another message. That way I don't have to approach their house, don't have to touch their doorbell or anything. And once they're outside, I would do the photos, as many as they wanted to get done. And I send them an email of their photos once I was done doing any minor tweaks that I had to do to the photos.
Okay, so in your Facebook post then, you were saying, hey, I will come out and photograph your family. Is that really what the message was to them?
Basically, and they thought it was a nice gesture to be spending my time out there for free, doing everything she had to do, taking photos, driving out there, getting home, spending hours on end on the computer, going through them all and then sending them off, so...
What type of equipment did you use? During the lockdown, of course, you're not wanting to get too close to people. So how did you stand off from your subjects?
I just had received a brand new lens for my camera, which was a 75 to 200 mil lens that is good for such things. Had an f2.8 setting on it. So I was able to stand basically on the sidewalk and have them on their porch or whatever, and I would take some really good pictures of them. So,
okay, so how many did you do in total?
Up to 90.
So you went out and visited 90 separate families during the lockdown and got their family portrait.
Yes.
That is awesome. That's so much time and effort and such an admirable project. It's so impressive. Did you have any kind of moments that were really unusual when you arrived at one home? Is there anything that kind of stands out?
Yes. The family where the mother comes out in a mask, and I thought nothing of it because it's COVID time. So I thought she's just taking extra precautions. But then everybody else of that family came out with the masks and some steampunk goggles on, and one had a shotgun and the other one had a knife on the waist. And I thought that was just too cool. It was probably my favorite. So I had another family come out wearing a complete rain suit, full face mask, with some signs that I don't want to be saying on on camera because of censorship. Another family that actually brought out some toilet paper, some Lysol and whatnot. So that kind of matched what was going on.
Did anybody pay you? I know you were doing this for free, but did anybody pay you?
I had some that actually gave me money out of just kindheartedness. They thought that it was too cool for a thing that I was doing, and they thought it was really nice what I was doing. So I insisted not to take any cash, and people insisted that they take the cash just for coming out and doing the photo. So
what is next for you? You've just essentially gone out and provided an amazing service for 90 families, and you have this incredible collage of photos to show for it. And where would you like to see this take you with your photography career?
Being able to do some more portraits, basically. That was my first time ever doing such a thing. So I'm new to this whole professional looking photography stuff. after taking your course, I learned a lot about how to position and whatnot. Basically, I got some more portraits coming up. I just finished having somebody talk to me about getting their portrait done. One of the family members has cancer and whatnot. So, and I am doing a charity for cancer where half the proceeds are going to go towards it. So,
awesome. So you said that you took the Photography Transformation Masterclass, and what has that done for your photography?
It's done a lot. I've seen improvement from being in the mountains with the family a couple of years back to just being in the mountains last week, and how much I've improved in taking photos from how I took them a couple of years back. So
excellent. So if you have any advice for someone who has a photography project idea, someone just has a concept, maybe it's just an idea in their head, what would your advice be to that photographer with their idea?
I say, be like me, just get out there and give it a try. Don't hurt to try. So it doesn't cost anything to give it a try, and just get out there and try it.
Okay. Awesome. Excellent advice. All right. Well, thank you so much. This is Tonya Davison from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. Tonya, you did such an amazing job with this photography project. You have 90 photos of 90 separate families. You've given those families a keepsake that they're going to have forever. You've built up your own photography portfolio at the same time. Well done. Congratulations. And thank you so much for joining me on this interview.
Thank you.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Isn't it incredible what one person can do and how one person with their photos can actually impact the lives of other people? You know, we have our slogan for Photography Academy, which is, I explore, I create, I inspire others. And Tonya clearly did that. She has inspired and impacted 90 families. And through her work, she has inspired me, and I hope that she has inspired you. Now, there's one thing that I know regarding these types of photo projects, or whenever you have an idea, I know from my life, one of the things that can hold me back, it's not necessarily being lazy, but it can be this feeling deep down inside of this internal fear. It's kind of hard to admit that, but so often when I have an idea for a project, the first feeling that I will feel is, oh, I don't know if I can do that. What if this bad thing happens? Or what if this other bad thing happens? What if I fail? And really, that all boils down to one word, and it is fear. So if you have a photo project, I can assure you from my own experience, there's only one way to overcome the internal fear that you may feel. And that is to take massive action. And when you take action, it overcomes the fear, it slays the fear with a sword of action, and you're going to get awesome results. And I know that if you have any idea, it's a good idea, and don't allow it to get crushed through fear. Just take action and get it done. If you are wondering what all this talk about the masterclass is about, here it is kind of in a nutshell, not the products you're going to get, but really what is it? Because the masterclass is not just a photography course. It's not a photography course. It's a framework. It's a system that you will use for the rest of your life to take every photo that you will ever take. And the system, it's a framework, kind of like a recipe. And you know that internationally famous chefs will use a recipe to make their award-winning dishes. And if they wrote out that same exact recipe and handed it to you, and you went into your kitchen and had the right ingredients, and you followed those same steps and that same recipe, you would be able to make the same award-winning dish that the famous chef made. And it's the exact same thing with this photography framework. It is a framework where I have broken down the system that you need to use that starts at the planning phase when you're planning out what your photo is going to be, all the way through to the post-processing and the editing phase. And when you follow that series of steps, no matter where you are or what type of photo that you want to take, you are going to be successful. And if you have any doubt of whether or not this will work for you, then you need to read the reviews on our website. Go to photographyacademy.com. At the very top, it says reviews. We have video reviews from people in our community. We have comments that have come in from Facebook. We have, I think, like 67 reviews or something that are all right there. We have lots more as well that I just haven't put on the website. The system works, the framework works. And as I said, it will change the way you take pictures for the rest of your life, so that the caliber of photos that you will be taking will be award-winning. So check out the Photography Transformation Masterclass. It will have an impact on your photography like you can't believe. And I hope to see you inside our private Facebook group, which is the Mastermind, and you get admission to that when you buy the Masterclass. So go out there and start your photography project, whatever it happens to be. Take massive action, slay fear, and take beautiful photos. Thanks. Bye-bye.
I am a photographer.
I am a photographer.
I am a photographer.
I am a photographer.
We are the photographers, and we are different from everyone else.
I explore.
I explore.
I explore.
We explore. We look for the beauty in the little things, and we find the greatness in the big things. We find beauty in places no one else sees.
I create.
I create.
I create.
We create. We create our own art. We freeze time. We create lasting memories and leave behind a legacy forever.
I inspire others.
I inspire others.
I inspire others.
We inspire, and through creating, we inspire others and move them through the emotion in our photos.
I am a photographer.
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 We are the photographers, and we are lifelong learners. We never stop moving forward. Join me, and together, let's explore, create, and inspire. Click the button and take the free web class to learn more.